serving the world with your work, with your effort. That is a Eucharist. That is the body of Christ.
Welcome to Doobie TV. I've got this amazing testimony by Jim Carrey. It is heartfelt. I think you'll enjoy it. Please subscribe and hit the like button.
Thank you for being your host and joining us here this morning. Jim has been a great friend of this place, and like anybody who kind of gets what we're doing here, what we're about is investing in people rather than wanting to incarcerate our way out of our problems. And so it's such an honor to call Jim a friend of this place, and happy that he's invested in you and in your future. So it's a privilege to introduce him now, a great friend of our humble home here, Homeboy Industries, Jim Carrey. Yeah!
Really happy to be part of this. This is a part of me, and thank you. I'd like to say thank you to Father Greg and his gigantic heart. There's hardly room for any of us in here with his heart. And I want to speak to the fact that I believe that this room is filled with God. And that you are heroes to me, and I admire you. Because when you step through these doors, and you decide to be a part of this family, you've made a decision to transcend and to leave darkness behind. And it takes a champion to make that decision. And I really want to speak to the fact that I've had some challenges in the last couple of years myself. Ultimately, I believe that suffering leads to salvation. And in fact, it's the only way that we have to somehow accept and not deny, but feel our suffering and feel our losses. And then we make one of two decisions. We either decide to go through the gate of resentment, which leads to vengeance, which leads to self-harm, which leads to harm to others, or we go through the gate of forgiveness, which leads to grace. And your being here is an indication that you've made that decision already. You've made the decision to walk through the gate of forgiveness to grace, just as Christ did on the cross. He suffered terribly, and he was broken by it to the point of doubt and a feeling of absolute abandonment, which all of you felt. And then there was a decision to be made. And the decision was to look upon the people who were causing that suffering, or the situation that was causing that suffering, with compassion and with forgiveness. And that's what opens the gates of heaven for all of us. So I wish that for all of you. I wish that for myself. I know that, you know, no matter what I've suffered, most of you have suffered worse than that. But that's why I admire you, because you're here, you know? And you will have grace, because this decision has been made. So I'm so glad to be with you. And to be a part of this. Thank you, Father Greg. Thank you, John. Something about the program that we're introducing here. I know that it's kind of an odd thing to consider. It's a very strange concept to most people, and especially to people that have suffered trauma and have trust issues or whatever, to trust that they can close their eyes for a moment or a couple of moments during the day and let go of the show that's going on in their heads. You know, we are so trapped, all of us, especially those who have suffered terrible trauma, to think of that as a real thing. And there is a difference between real danger and imagined danger, and it's hard to turn that off. And meditation, for me, and for a lot of people, has been a way to turn that off, you know, and or recognize that those thoughts are just thoughts. And like clouds that cross the sky, they will pass on. And to gently pull yourself back to a place of peace. And just to stop the spiral of thought, man, we get up in the morning and we open our eyes and the show begins, you know, and it's a thriller for some people. And you can't help but get caught up in it. And it's important a couple of times during the day to stop and go, wait, this is just as real as those thoughts. I am bigger than these thoughts. I am bigger than this body. You know, they talk about omnipresence in church, and nobody really thinks about what that means. What it means is every cell of your body is God. Everything is God. Everything is divine. So, when you do good things, when you decide to transcend the negativity and attempt to do something positive for you, for your family, you are the heart of God. You are the eyes of God. When you speak from that place, you are God's voice. And when you make a loaf of bread in this place, in this kitchen, that is a Eucharist. You're blessing people with your work. You're serving the world with your work, with your effort. That is a Eucharist. That is the body of Christ. You know? And I thank you for everything you're doing. You're amazing. You're champions. I admire you.